Alright, so, this is, I don't know, I guess you could call it part two of my stream. When I left off, for dinner, I, left us here at Kakariko Village. We just talked to Impa, who kind of told us just basically the whole story, like what's been going on and what we need to do. We need to find the four divine beasts, or rather we need to go to the areas of the map where the four... races are who know about the divine beasts. I have also, like, I went and I rewatched that. I watched a video of, like, tips for beginners. So there's a couple of things. It was non-spoilers because I didn't want any spoilers, but there's a couple of things. Like, we tried killing, there's like a rock creature that I found after I left the plateau. There's apparently two of them, like, back to back. One of them is in the plateau, and then one of them is right at the bottom of the plateau. The one at the bottom is harder, like, a lot harder than the one on the plateau. And I, of course, because I'm me, found the harder one, which is why I was getting really frustrated and I couldn't kill it. So I kind of want to go back to the plateau and find him. Honestly, I just want to do a little bit of exploration. Instead of, you know, immediately progressing the story, because that's really the beauty of this game, is that you can do it in whatever order you like, honestly. And I love that. Like, I love that I get to choose how I play it. It's just... I'm kind of speechless. I had a lot of doubts about this game and how it's broken up the formula, the traditional formula of how Zelda games usually work. Excuse me. But it turns out that it's amazing. Like, it's amazing. I think that... I mean, trust me, Twilight Princess still has a very... very deep spot in my heart, but this game is a contender. Like, I think this might be my new favorite Zelda game. Now, I want to try something here. This guardian is a pain in the ass, and I want to see... Oh, wow. Okay, I can do that, and it did get damaged a little bit. So I'm interested to know if I can just continuously, like... bomb these things. He is taking damage, but it's taking... This is gonna take forever at this point. Hey, you. Wake up. Yeah, this is gonna take absolutely forever. Maybe I don't want to do this. Maybe there's better ways to spend my time. What I do want to do, though... Okay, is now I want to go. Come on, Link. Go, 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 go. Having the extra stamina is really nice. I think I made the right decision in upgrading my stamina meter before my heart meter. Now, I don't know where this rock guy is gonna be. That's the problem. He's a rock. So, like, it's just gonna look like a regular big boulder. Which is kind of problematic because there's, you know, there's a lot of rocks around here. But I guess we're looking specifically for, like, a big... boulder, so I'm gonna try to get some high ground and just look around and try to, like, figure out where it could possibly be. Ah! No, that's too big of a boulder, right? There is a bokoblin camp, though, and I remember seeing that and being like, oh, we'll come back here later. Well, now is later, so let's take care of this now. Oh, I did buy some arrows, right? So I do have some more arrows now. Oh, I don't want those, though. I don't want those. I want regular arrows. Okay, I gotta headshot this guy. Ah, gotcha. That feels so satisfying to headshot those guys. Now, one thing that I realized I could do is with this kind of stuff, I want to actually... Oh, no. Oh, no. Why? Wow. No. Get away from me. Get away from me. Blow it up. There we go. Alright, let's pull out the sword. I want to try something new here, too. Okay, that wasn't what it was. There's supposedly a flurry attack that you can do with your weapons that does, like, a lot of damage. And... hello to anybody who just joined the channel. I know it's got a couple more people in here. What I was saying is, like, there's a flurry attack that you can do when an enemy jumps at you. You basically want to, like, do a jump. Ooh, spiked Boko Club. I think that's good, right? How much damage? What is this? A Boko Bat? Let's drop... Okay, hold on. That's not really what I wanted to do, game. I want to go into weapons, and I want to drop... Yeah, I want to get rid of this piece of shit weapon. Spiked Boko Club. That's what I want. 12! 12 damage as opposed to 4. That, yeah, and we'll continue using the, broadsword, I guess, because it's almost broken anyway. I did clear out all the bokoblins, right? So where is that chest at? There was, like, a chest that just appeared somewhere. Oh, it's inside! Ah. This is what I was trying to do. Blow it up, please. There we go. Okay, well, you didn't get a very good view of it there, because I suck, I keep pressing the Sheikah slate by accident. What is that? Is it just a regular crappy bow? Yeah, Boko bow. We don't want that. But I do want to climb up here and get this, because hopefully there's something decent in it. Fire arrows! Nice! Alright, those are pretty convenient to have. Those were, like, I think 80 gold over in Kakariko Village, just to buy 5 of them. So that's pretty good to get out of a chest, but I still want to find this rock guy. Where could he possibly be? That's what I want to know. Like, obviously, like, you take a look at the map. We've been a lot of places. We've been all the way to Kakariko Village, and we uncovered a lot of the plateau, but I by no means actually finished everything we can do here. So that's why I'm kind of backtracking now. I want to explore and just see, like, what I can get out of coming back here with, like, more items and such. What's up here? I don't think I ever went up here. Oh, that's just a boulder that I could have pushed down to deal with any bokoblins that were down there. That's, wow. Yeah, they would have been toast if I had known about that. Oh, is that him? I think that might be him. Please, game. No, that's not him. Damn it, now every boulder! I'm gonna look at every boulder like it's the mini-boss guy, and it's not gonna be, and I'm gonna be very sad all the time. I don't know even where to begin looking for him. There's some boulders up here I can push. Is there a bokoblin encampment down here? I must have already killed them too. Damn. Yeah, I'm not sure really where I wanna go. Oh, okay, I see you. Yeah, I know, you're coming. Okay, jump attack? Wait, no, ah, damn it! Oh, I pressed the wrong button. Damn it, and I pressed the wrong button again. What is the jump attack? Jump and Y, right? No, pull out the weapon first, jump and Y. Yeah, that's what apparently that just actually broke my weapon anyway. I didn't think it used durability if I wasn't actually attacking anything. Boko Bat kinda sucks. Let's use the club. I really want to try a jump attack. I want to get it right this time. Come on, you. Attack me, jump at me. No, like, jump at me. Yeah, whatever. That did pretty much decimate him, but that wasn't what I was trying to do. There is something called, like, a flurry attack. I think it's like, if an enemy jump attacks you, and you jump attack it, then you can kind of, you get, like, an option to press a button to do a flurry attack, which, like, you just slash away at them, and it does a lot of damage, and ooh, there's gotta be something good. What is that? Is that just, like, a pile of leaves? Ooh, you know what we have? I have the Korok leaf. Is that how I use this? Can I blow these out of the way? Is that a thing? No. Is that really not a thing? Okay, let's try using the Boko Bat, because I don't want to do it with a good weapon. Let's charge this up and see if, like, this does anything. There is something in here! I just clearly hit something. Maybe bombs? Let's try that. Put that down. Oh no, I didn't want to throw it. Damn it. I gotta wait for- Oh! That still worked, though! Apparently. Pick that up. This should be a... Yeah, there we go. It's a Korok. Yaha! You found me. Korok seeds. That's our third one. I still don't know what happens with these things. Like, I don't know what they're used for, but I'll take it. God, this is so pretty. I love this game. It's just amazing looking. A little bit of slowdown here, a little bit of frame drops, but I mean, that's to be expected when you've got a ton of grass particles in pretty much any game, even if you've got like... Ooh, is the traveler's bow any good? No, put that away, Link. I wanna look and see what bows I have. Traveler's bow is only 5 damage, so I'll just leave that. I could cook. Well, actually could- no, this is not even on fire. Let me look and see what my torch does, because this can't possibly just light stuff, right? Yeah, no, I have to have fire in order to light anything with the torch. So I don't understand what the good of having a torch is. Maybe to light dark places? I don't know. Go back to the Boku Club, the spiked one. Is that like a cow or like a bison? Oh, tree, you're in the way. Oh no. Oh no, it's running away. Oh, it's a hog. I think it's like a hog. Okay, well. Oh, there's a bunch there. Okay. See if I can get a good headshot on it. Yes! Got both of them. Nice. The other one was gonna bolt for it, but I got it before it could run away. Tons of raw meat. This is what I'm talking about. Earlier, I was like low on food all the time, and I kept saying, oh, I need to go and, you know, collect more stuff to make food, and then I never did, and I kept finding myself in a situation where I needed more food and never could find it. But now we're getting tons of it, which is good. Nice. Okay. I thought that didn't drop anything for a second. I was about to be really mad. I know there's another one over there, but I still want to find this rock guy. There's supposed to be one on the plateau, and I really don't want to have to... this looks suspicious. Hold on. I don't want to say I'm 99% sure that I know what this is, but I think I know what this is. So let me equip, like, the best weapon I have right now, and then we will get closer. Is this it? Ah, it is! It is it! I found it! Aha! Alright, I'm ready for you this time, Stone Talus. Alright, break off your arm. Okay, come on, Link, now's not the time. Oh! Oh, he's on- okay, I have to do it one more time then, hold on. Throw- no- oh, Jesus Christ! Ow, that was a lot of damage! That was- oh, I'm not dead yet, though, come on. Food. Cooked food. We don't have cooked food, damn it. Okay, oh, we do, wait, we have this thing. It's so good. You know what? Oh, when cooked into a dish. No, I want to keep it. Crap. I guess I'm just going to be eating raw meat, which is really disgusting, but I cannot die to this guy. Like, I would hate myself. Oh, really? That was not- how was that fair at all? Alright, I gotta eat more now. Wow. Alright, I'm gonna do it right this time. There we go, throw and blow it up. That didn't actually work. Alright, come on. How am I meant to dodge that? Jesus. Can you just- okay, he's gonna fall down. He should fall down, right? Wait. There's physics in this game. The physics is- okay. I'm gonna try, instead of blowing up his arms, because this is obviously not working out very well for me. Oh no, please tell me this doesn't make me go all the way back to Kakariko Village. Don't make me go back to Kakariko Village, please! It's so far away, and I don't really remember. Well, I kinda remember how I got here. I want to kill this rock guy. This is like my main goal right now. Oh, it put me right back here. Okay, I'm gonna, before he even gets a chance to do anything, I'm just gonna throw that his way. That didn't do anything. Okay. Back up then. Wait until our bomb. Jesus Christ. Okay, well, I got it, but barely. I'm gonna switch to my other types of bombs because they roll a little bit further. Okay, well, that only did like half of a, or a quarter of a heart. There we go. I need to run up his arm. How do I? Oh, Jesus, get out of the way, Vinny. Oh, no, not you, Sheikah Slate. This is really bad time. Sheikah Slate, okay. I want him to do this, I think. Okay, that broke his arm, actually. Oh, he's getting his arm back now. Can I seriously, like, do I have to use bombs? Ooh, okay. I'm scared of you! Can you, like, yes, this is what I want you to do. Yes! Come on, get up there, Link, get up there! Alright, now pull out the sword. No, pull out the sword, stay on top of him, stay on top of him. Come on, slash away. Yes! This is it. This is what I want to do. Come on, Link. You can do it. We're doing a lot of damage. Let's just keep slashing. Alright, well, I got hurt. Please, Link, get up, get up, get up! Don't die, don't die. Anything but that, don't die. Just don't die. Nope, Sheikah Slate. Damn it, Sheikah Slate. I hate you. Come on, throw your other fist at me. Oh. Oh, damn it. Why did I do that? Throw and blow him up. Can you fall down? There we go. Climb up! Alright. We're doing it. Come on. He's like less than half health now. Let's go, Link! Link, come on! Link, you can do it! Okay. Okay. I am going to... Can I actually eat while I'm, like... How am I able to eat when I'm, like, on the ground like that? Whatever, I'm not gonna question it. Alright. He's gonna fall down again. I wanna climb up. Come on, Link. Link! Oh, what are you doing? What are you doing? Climb up the arm, climb up the arm. Climb up the arm! Okay! I'm scared. No, Sheikah, damn it. I hate that that is on that button. I wonder if I can change that. Is he gonna fall down again? Yes! Go, 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 go! Come on. Yes, yes! Oh, he's dead! Yes! Finally! That feels really good. That's like the first, I guess the first mini-boss I've really beat. Ruby, okay, precious red gem mine from large ore. These sell for a high price. Yeah, that's mostly why I wanted to kill him, because he drops a bunch of amber, and he drops a ruby, which, supposedly sells for a lot in the shops, and will actually be able to buy more stuff now, which is really what I wanted to do, but... Alright, got ton of Hylian shrooms, and we're... I think that that's really kind of what I wanted to take care of. There is, apparently, like, a frost-resist tunic or whatever that you can get somewhere in the plateau, but I don't really know exactly where it is. Ooh, what's this? Collectible? What? Oh, this is gonna lead me to a Korok, isn't it? I bet you it is. Yep. Just follow the flowers. Yep, there we go. I remember watching this in a video. So that's our, I think, our fourth Korok seed. Bye-bye! I still don't know what they're used for. They're probably used for, like, I don't know, upgrading inventory space or something? Ooh, a Bokoblin camp. How many arrows do I have? I have enough. Damn it, I missed him. Too low. Come on. The motion controls are a little bit... How is that not hitting him? Alright, apparently that... It kind of... Maybe I'm getting the perspective wrong here, but... Oh, you know what? Also, I don't want to use my really awesome sword for this. I want to go down to some other kind of weapon. You. What just... Whoa. My soldier's bow broke? How? How did that... Wait, no. No, no, no. Put that away. Alright. Let's do it this way. I thought I could re-equip a bow. Damn, that was a good bow, too. Well, I guess maybe bows do have durability, then. You're supposed to be able to knock, yeah, you're supposed to be able to knock shields out of enemies' item, or out of enemies' hands if you have, like, a blunt weapon. So that's another good thing about the combat system, is that different types of weapons will help you in different combat situations. Are these arrows? Yeah, that's an arrow. I need to shoot him with an arrow, though, to kill him. I think. God, finally! Why was I not... That was such an easy shot. I don't understand how I was missing so much. I guess my depth perception was a little bit off on, like, the trajectory of how I, you know, where I needed to aim. There's a Bokobo. Let's see what's up in this chest? Hopefully something good. Maybe some arrows, since I'm running low. And I like range combat. Oh, it's an opal. That's nice. I like the range combat in this game, so... and I wanna... I think that if I die, what I've done doesn't get saved. So, like, if I were to die now, then it would bring me back to, like, right before I killed the rock boss, I think. And I don't want to go all the way back. Oh, hey, Blue, I see you in the chat now. Sorry, I'm so, like, entranced by the game that I sometimes forget to look over in chat and see who's there. This is new. A plant that grows in quieter areas of Hyrule. Cook it to increase stealth. Okay. This game, I don't know if you've ever played any Zelda games, Blue, but this, it's kind of like an MMO, but in Zelda format. Oh, and there's bees. I heard them. No, Link, don't climb up the tree. Get off the tree. Damn it. Run away. I'm about to be swarmed by bees. But yeah, it's really, like, it reminds me a lot of an MMO, because you've got weapons. I mean, the weapons have durability, but you get them off of enemies, so there's, like, loot. There's, like, traditional loot. And then there's also, like, a cooking system. So, like, usually in Zelda, you just kill an enemy and it drops a heart, and then the heart heals you. But in this game, in order to restore your health, you have to eat something. So... that's kind of cool. I'm enjoying it a lot more than I thought I would. I thought it was going to be more of an inconvenience, but weapons are really, really plentiful, so it's not like you're ever really in super danger of running out. The last one you played was the N64 one. Probably Ocarina of Time, I'd imagine. Everyone has played Ocarina of Time at some point in their life. Yeah, it's super fun. I'm enjoying this. I don't know, I kind of am enjoying just exploring stuff. Even though this is the plateau, this is like the beginning area of the game. Is there something up here? Yeah, this looks suspicious. Ooh, what is that? Eggs? Bird eggs. Nice. Hopefully a bird doesn't come down and attack. Wait, can I take the nest? No, okay. I don't know why I need the nest, but maybe I can make something with it. Ooh, there's arrows here. I really need to figure out how to light fires. I think I need, like, flint. And I don't know where to get flint from. And I also keep seeing these damn... yes! Oh! I can collect them! That's what they are! Sunset fireflies glow gently in the dark. When cooked with monster parts, the compound that causes it to glow results in an elixir that will allow you to move more quietly, so it gives you stealth. Okay. Do I have to be, like, really close to them? Yeah. They can't- ooh. Can I get you? Yay! I got that one, I think. Did I get it? Wait. No. Wrong button. Wait, what? Oh, no, that is the right button. I want to go back to inventory, though. I didn't get it. I only have one. Catch you! Alright, fine. I don't know, maybe there's like a bug net or something. Ooh, what's this? Silent shroom. Cooking addition locks nutrients in its cap. Stealthy, yeah, so that's... if I cook that into a meal... ooh, have I already talked to this guy? Oh yeah, this is the guy with the leaves. Never mind, I'm already backtracking now at this point. I'm gonna go and teleport then. You did the part 2 Mask 1 too? Oh yeah, Majora's Mask. Majora's Mask is a good game too. I enjoyed Majora's Mask. So, Kakarika Village is where we were. We're supposed to travel here. But this region has, like... the thing about this game is, instead of traditional, like, dungeons in, like, a Zelda game, you have... they have 120 of these, like, smaller shrines. And then there's, like, 4 larger dungeons as well, in addition to those. But you go into the shrines, and you do kind of, like, a little... I don't know, 5 to 10 minute long little dungeon-y puzzle-like thing. And then you get a spirit orb out of it, and then once you have 4 spirit orbs, you can turn them into a statue, a goddess statue, to get either 1 extra unit of life, or you can increase your stamina meter to, like, run and climb and swim for longer, or glide, which I'm about to show here, but I need to figure out where I want to go first, because I want to look for, like, a shrine, and you can normally see them from far away. Like, there's one over there, but it's blue, which means I've already beat it. If it were red, it would mean that I hadn't beat it yet. Maybe should I go off that way? What is in that direction on my map? That's like over there. And that's a shrine I went to. Drifting, travel. Oh, I remember that shrine. Okay, maybe, I don't know. I'll explore this way, why not? Do the paraglider here. But yeah, I can't glide with this forever because it uses stamina. And like, also you can't swim without stamina. So if I were to fall into this water and then run out of stamina, I would just drown. So it's really, it's definitely a survival game. Ooh, what is that up there? What is that? It's like a... Okay, hello. Oh, I didn't want to pull out a bomb. Blow that up before I kill myself with it. Although, now that I think about it, bombs are probably a pretty decent way of killing things without having to spend resources. So, like, let me try that. Yeah. Oh, well. I have to kill the head in order to actually kill these guys for good. Pick up... No, I didn't... Pick those up, Link. Hello, choo-choo. Give me that. Alright. With all those distractions aside, what I wanted to do... Climb up here. Whoop, don't fall. Vertical surfaces become slick. Oh my gosh, it... Really? So I'm falling down the... I can't mountain climb in the rain. Wow, talk about, like, realistic survival game. Is there a way around? Ooh, and I see elk. No, come back! Damn it! Come back here! Oh, fine. Alright, I'll just take the silent shroom and be on my way then. Come on! Get up there, Link. Good. Over here is where I saw it? Yeah. What is this? It looks like a pinwheel. Is this gonna be a flower? Oh, this is gonna be a Korok, isn't it? Oh! Jesus Christ! No! Link, please climb. Please climb. Just hop all the way up. Come on, use that stamina, Link! Oh, I'm dead. Well, I'm not dead, but I'm definitely falling. Can I go around the other way? Maybe. Alright, get down, Link. Stop climbing. I'm just gonna ignore these guys. I want whatever that is, and I kept hearing a Korok sound, so I have a feeling it's got something to do with a Korok, but... Yeah, I'm not sure. Whoa, look at the moon. That's crazy. What are you? Like, oh, wait! I know what to do. I think I know what to do. Korok leaf? Maybe? Is that gonna make that spin faster? Link. Oh, wait! Oh! Targets have appeared! So if I shoot these... let's do you. No, I said, let's do you. Come on. Stop. They're like dodging my attack, really. Oh my god, I'm gonna run out of arrows before I get this. Oh, Jesus. Oh, I'm like also moving. The motion controls are not being my friend right now. Maybe I won't. I don't know. I'm still debating on whether or not I want to even use the motion controls. Okay, I got that one. I've got 5 arrows left, though. Finally! Alright. This better be a Korok seed. Alright, good. Yahaha! Alright, 5 Korok seeds. What do you do, Korok seeds, though? Like, you better be something good. There's apparently 900. I'm not even making that number up. 900 Korok seeds that you can find in this game. When asked if this game was 100% completable, the developers basically laughed in the face of the person who asked that question, because, like, yes, technically it probably is beatable, but not easily. Okay, so they're all dead. Eyeball, some other stuff, some key swing, and a choo-choo. Oh, and that broke. Damn, weapons always breaking. The durability, I don't know. I have not decided if I like it or hate it. Like, it's not a super big inconvenience, but it is something that you have to, like, keep in mind for sure. I'm just trying to, like, collect things at this point because I want to not run out of food ever again. Because that was a horrible experience. What's up here? Have I been this way already? The other interesting thing about this game is that the map, like, you just get it already filled in, essentially. Wow! That was a nice shot, but it's not dead yet. Oh, come on. Come on. Oh, wow. Yes! Die, goat. Pick that up. Get some raw meat. I don't know if I've been this way. Yeah, for the completionist, it's not really feasible to you know, finish the game 100%. And unfortunately, I typically am a completionist. I mean, you know, like, in WoW, before I got, like, super burnt out by Legion, I, you know, had a million alts and did tons of achievements and everything else. I love completing things in games and you know, doing as much as I can. It's just, I don't know. I do plan to complete this game. I don't know if I'm going to complete it all on stream. I might complete most of it on stream, but I'll probably do a lot, like, outside of the stream as well, just because, like, that's a lot of stuff to do. I want to dash over here, because you can somehow barehandedly catch fish. Come on, go get him. 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 Ooh, that's a big one over there. Staminoka bass. This Hyrule bass got to be the biggest fish by never getting caught until now. Restores a lot of stamina. Ooh. And an armored carp. Calcium deposits in the scales of this ancient fish make them as hard as armor. Cooking it into a dish will fortify your bones, temporarily increasing your defense. Okay. Oh, shit. I need to get out of the water. I need to get out of the water. Ooh. Wow. Mighty carp, the freshwater fish. Blah, blah, blah. Cooked will temporarily increase your attack power. That fish basically just, like, killed itself. Suicidal fish. Whatever. He'll be my dinner later on. What's up here? I'm supposed to have... Wait a minute. Let me go back in here. Sheikah sensor. Turret... Is it on? Yeah, it is on. So I must be, like, nowhere near a shrine. Are there no shrines in this freaking area? There's, like, flamingos. Gotcha. And the other one's just gonna run off, so I'm not even gonna bother with him. Getting lots of food, though. I'm liking this. Maybe I'll have to go back to Kakariko Village to, like, cook a bunch of... Ooh, grasshoppers. Can I catch them? Come here, grasshopper. No! Come back! I don't know. Maybe I could have. Oh, I can sneak. That's right. I keep forgetting that sneaking is, like, a thing. Now, there's a bunch of apple trees here. Let's chop some down. I want to chop this one down because it has a ton of apples. And we'll take the, we'll take that and turn it into wood. No, Link. Do not attack the apples. I want to pick those up. Because we need food. Ooh, I got an acorn! So you may have a completion while competition while foraging. Add one to a meal for nutty seasoning. Whatever that means. Let's use this up, because, like, really, the only thing I... Well, maybe I always want to have, like, at least one hatchet on me. But I'll get some more wood, and then we'll call that a day as far as the hatchet goes. Put that away, because I don't want to be caught without one of those. Ew, why do I have a tree branch? Yeah, I know the Bokoblin arm is badly damaged, that's why I have it equipped. Do I see any more shrines? I mean, there's... The crazy thing about this game is that if you can see it, you can, like, actually go to it, and it's, like, a real place. So, like, I don't know, maybe they're using some trickery to rend, you know, the far-off places, and, you know, make the game not, like, have horrible FPS drops, but... Like, it's just insane to me. This is just one region, too, of this whole world. Like, it's such a large game. I want to go back to Kakariko Village, though, now, I think. Please? Oh, can I... Are you serious? I can't teleport back to... Oh, game. Really? Why? Why can I not travel back to Kakariko Village? That's stupid. Well, I guess I'm going to Dueling Peaks Tower again. And I'm gonna make my way over there manually. That sucks. If I had known that, like, I don't know. I would have found a shrine closer to Kakariko before heading all the way back to this area. So who else is in the stream? I know Blue's in here, and Blue is a guild member of mine in WoW. I used to raid hardcore for anyone, whoever is watching. I used to hardcore raid in WoW, or semi-hardcore anyway. And I recently quit about 3 weeks ago to take time off to do my YouTube and Twitch channels. And so far, I am, like, really loving the decision to do that, because I'm having a whole lot of fun. Just, you know, playing video games and recording and getting to turn it into something fun. And it feels more productive to me than WoW. Right now, World of Warcraft is just a little... I think it's just a little too grindy for my tastes. It's always normally a grind, but it's exceptionally grindy right now, unfortunately. I just ran out of stamina. What are these? Can I pick those up? No. There should be some horses nearby. Do I see any? No. There were some horses here earlier, but I guess they're gone now. I just want to get back to Kakariko Village so I can, like, sell some stuff and maybe buy some better armor. But I don't know. Let's glide. Oh, I said let's glide! Thank you, Link. Wow. Now, I want to come over here, and I want to, like... I want to sneak up behind... Can I sneak with a bomb in my hand? No. Oh, God. Okay. Did that hurt me? I hope that didn't hurt me. Uh-oh, they see me. I think they see me. I'm not here. I'm not even here. Throw the bomb! And blow them up! Okay. Wow. I kind of really want them to go near the dynamite. Yes! Go near the dynamite! Yes! Okay, shit, there's a ton of them, though. Okay, hold on. Hold the phone. Sure, I'll eat the meat skewer. And I need to equip a better weapon as well. Like, I think that this calls for a 20 weapon because— Oh, shit! Wow! That was not fair. How was that fair? You die. What the fuck was that? Holy shit, he decimated me with that. I guess weapons that are on fire do more damage than other weapons. Which I guess makes sense, but I'll have to come back to the— I don't know, I could probably still do something about that encampment if I'm smarter about it. I wonder... Okay, I want to try something. No, I don't want to try that. I want to jump. Jump and glide. I want to see if I can get to the top of this. And maybe if I climb to the top of this, they, like, won't be able to hit me from here. And then I can just snipe them or something. Oh, I only have one regular arrow left. Fuck. Okay, well, that did hit him. No, no. Oh, damn it. Well, It doesn't seem like they can hit me from here, so that's good news. Can I just, like, cheese this? Oh. Well, that one got blown up, but that's not really doing— They have so much health! I mean, my god! And that didn't hit them. I need to use the explosives in, like, a crafty way. Or... Maybe I can use my Magnesis rune? No, I'm too far away. Yeah, I'm too far away. Shit. Okay, No, I don't want to throw that. I want to... I don't really want to use my fire arrows, but I kind of feel like I have no choice. If I... Okay, maybe... Oh, that worked! Are they taking, like, hot damage? No. That just seems like such a waste of fire arrows to me. But, I don't know, that guy did wreck me, so maybe it's worth it. Alright, well, he's dead. Maybe I can headshot this guy. I don't know if headshots with fire arrows even make a difference. What is the arrow? No, arrows, please. Ice arrows, sure. Okay, that froze him. Are there gonna be a bunch coming up behind me? Probably. Come on. Come on, go kill him. Okay, he's dead. Oh, I got a rupee! I didn't know things could drop rupees. That's like, actually, believe it or not, the first time I've seen something actually drop a rupee in the game. Am I being hunted by something? I need arrows. What's in here? Arrows? Amber. Arrows? I think an arrow through the head kills almost anything. Whether it's on fire doesn't matter. You would think so. Come here, choo-choo. Come here. Oh shit, there's another blue one. The blue ones do more damage. Oh wait, I need a weapon. Shit. Wait. Food, please, cooked food. Sure. And then we'll go to uncooked food. I need something that like restores like 3/4 of a heart or something. I don't really have anything that, all right, whatever. That will have to do. Oh, and I still didn't equip a weapon. Yeah, okay, soldier's claymore, that's fine. No, Link. Oh my god, he is. Stop poking me with your stick! What? The blue ones do so. I need to kill the blue ones before I kill anything else. Jesus, this Zelda game, and this, I've heard this everywhere. Every single person that's played it so far has said this is far and away like the hardest Zelda yet, because it's brutal. You're put into a world where sometimes the enemies you're gonna face are harder than you really should. Like, you might be able to find yourself in an area where like the enemies are way more difficult than you know, maybe where your like gear is at the moment. Come here. Hey, come over here. I have a surprise for you. Come here, Bokoblin. Did that work? Oh wow, that actually caught me on fire. Ooh, a red rupee. That's 20 rupees. That's really nice. What is this? Boko spear? I can't carry any more melee weapons, really? Oh, stupid tree branch, really? Why do I have a tree branch? Go away, get out of my inventory. The inventory management in this game is a little annoying, unfortunately. And do I really want to? See, like, the torch, the axe, and the leaf are, like, the weapons that I really, really, really don't want to get rid of. Mostly because, like, they're used for other things other than fighting. Maybe I'll just drop this. How much is the Boko spear, though? 2. Are you kidding me? Alright, we'll drop that anyway. We'll equip this. At least I don't have to re-kill the guys that I've already killed. More rupees over here. I'll take it. That's really nice. Is there anything in here that I can get? Like, any arrows? No. No. Oh, what is that? Roasted bass. Okay. Is there even a reason for me to kill everything in this encampment? Alright, go Link. Go. Oh, he just died. Okay. I think the archers have less health, because they seem to always die, like, no matter what. And yes, regular arrows! Regular good arrows that don't, like, do weird things. Okay. Here, though. Nope, not you, Magnesis Rune. I want my remote bomb. I'll pull that out, and I want to... Why do I keep doing that? Pick it up. Can I pick it back up? There we go. That's the button I wanted. Oh shit. Okay. Run away, Link. Run! Link! Oh my god, why is it so fast? It's so fast! Oh, and I'm out. Oh, no, 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 no. No, 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 no. And that weapon broke. Alright, whatever. Claymore time then, I guess. I do not. Ooh, I can pick that up though. Take that, and yeah, we're gonna kill you with your own weapon. Eat shit, Blue Goblin. I hate you. I hate you and all of your family. Okay. Got rupees. There's another red one with like a stick. Come here. Come on. Come over here. Come fight me. Come on. Come at me, Bokoblin. Okay, I was kind of kidding. You're just gonna swing that thing wildly around? That seems... How is that fair? I can't even get close to you because you're just gonna... Okay, there we go. Jeez. Bokoblin horn. I'll take it. There's another blue one in there. Is there even any reason for me to go in there? I wonder. Okay, I'm gonna try this. Ready? Go! Oh, no, I did it again! Oh, I did it again. I keep pressing. Okay, the reason I keep pressing the wrong button is on this controller, there are actually four triggers. There's a right, a front right, and then a left and a front left, and they do different things. And the arrows, your bow and arrow, is on one of the right triggers, and then to throw your bomb is also on, it's on the other right trigger, the one that's not the arrows. So every time I go to, oh, and I have to kill these guys over, yes, I do. I'm angry. I'm, like, actually angry now. Alright. Come on. If I shoot that, will it blow up? No. I missed it. Oh, he's got fire. You know what? Fuck this encampment. I don't even see any treasure in there. I don't know why I would even really want to go in there in the first place, so maybe I'll head back here when I've got some better armor. I literally have two armor worth of defense because I'm still wearing the... Are you still following me? Wow! Dude, take a hint! Go back to your encampment. Leave me alone. Oh, no. Oh, no. Are you... This does not seem fair. I seem very outnumbered here. Is the other guy still following? No. Okay, I'm just gonna run. I'm running away. I am retreating. I am retreating! Jesus Christ. Okay. Claymore equip. Bow is fine. Shield is fine. I'm gonna eat some food. And then I'm going to destroy you mercilessly. I just threw my weapon. Okay, that's not what I wanted to do. Can I even do anything about... Okay, wait. Yes! Okay, come on, horsey. No. Horse, come back here. Okay, and then L to soothe, right? Come on, calm down, horse, calm down. Good horse. Okay, we have a horse now, finally. Well, again, this is the second horse I've had so far. And that's not the way I want to go. I need to find a new shrine, though. This is kind of part of the problem. Where do I want to go? Oh, I want to go across the bridge. Okay, I remember how to get back now. Come on, horse. Off we go. Sorry, birds. Wait, did they just die from my... Oh my god, they did. They did. They died and dropped food. I'm taking all of this. No. Go away, Sheikah Slate. The move the camera button is the right analog, and when you press the right analog, like when you press it down, it puts you in a first-person, like, Sheikah mode view, and so I... Probably like 60 times now already, I have accidentally gone into like the first person mode when I've been just trying to like move the camera. But I think I want to head up this way and I want to save these boosts because last time I went through here there was like an electrical keys, which is like a bat, and it wrecked me because I didn't have enough speed boost to get past it without dying. But it looks like it's not here anymore, so that's good. Come on, horse. Let's go. We're almost there. No, come on, you can make it up that. You did it before. Well, your friend did, rather. Up, horse. Horse, you can make it. Get up the mountain. Go. There we go. Huh, that was more difficult than it needed to be. All right, we're almost Kakarika Village. It should just be right around the corner here. I should get better at horse combat, too. I need to figure out, like, the controls for horse combat, because then these guys riding around on horses wouldn't be such a problem. But we're almost there. I see it. Entrance is right here. Come on, go horse, faster. And I'm getting a little thing that's saying shrine nearby, which is weird, because like I'm almost at the village, so I don't... Oop. Oh wow, I just leapt off the horse. grab those drumsticks. The horse can't really, well, maybe I'll just ride him to the entrance anyway. The horses can't go in the village, so he's just gonna stop once I get here anyway. Alright, get off you. This village is amazing. I came here at nighttime, and it's probably not as pretty during the day. But oh my god, this village is amazing. Yes, I know a shrine is nearby. I understand. Where is the... I want the, like... the store for clothing, because I want to see if I can buy some better armor. I really, really don't like being so defensively weak. Like, pretty much a one hit from a blue bokoblin destroys me, and that just makes me feel sad. So someone's growing carrots. I can't pick them, though, because that would be rude. They're not my carrots. Oh no, don't go in there, Link. Where is the shop at? It was like somewhere over on this side of the village. Is it down here? Oh, last time I was here it was nighttime. I tried coming over here to this like pumpkin patch. Want some pumpkins? Maybe? I don't know. Hmm? Ah, it's rare to see a young lad like you in a village like this. You aren't part of the Yiga clan, are you? No. Ha, I'm just pulling your leg. You look so serious, I couldn't help but goad you a bit. Wow, that's rude. We call those who swear allegiance to Calamity Ganon the Yiga clan. They, well, let's just say they don't take kindly to those who would stand against Ganon. It seems they're active again, ever since that big earthquake the other day. But don't worry, I don't think you're part of that awful Yiga clan. I can figure that much out just by looking at you. Please don't hold it against me. Here, take this in exchange. Fortified pumpkin. When cooked, the toughness manifests itself by considerably upping defense. Nice. Kakariko Village specialty. They're delicious. If you want more, I can give you some. Just stop by the fields and say hello. You'll give me some? Oh, yeah, no. You're not gonna give me some. You're gonna sell me some, maybe. Here, this is what I wanted. Cute new outfits. Enchanted, right this way. Yeah, this is what I wanted. This armor is insane. It doesn't have very much defense, but it gives you stealth up. 600, 700, 500 rupees. That full set is so crazy. These are expensive in their own right. I think I need, let's see, I need 180 plus 90, so 270 rupees total to buy that. But I think I might just actually do that. But first, I need to sell. What would you like to sell? No, I don't want to sell the wood. Hmm, you had your eye on the wood? Well, you can't have my wood, lady. Get it? Oh god, it's horrible. I'll never say that again in my lifetime. Ruby. Oh, holy shit. That is 200 and... Yes, I'm selling that. Yes. Yes, ma'am. 210 rupees? Are you kidding me? That's awesome. I'm already, like, almost to my goal of what I need for the outfit. Is there anything else that I have that's, like, nice and valuable? That, like, can't be used in crafting. Because, like, I think amber can be used in crafting. I don't think opal can, though, but I'm not sure. So, like, I'll sell one of these, I guess. Yeah, I'll sell one for now. And then I want to buy this outfit. What is the Clary collection? High-end collection curated by me. Personally selected each and every item in here by using my blah, 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 blah. This is just... Okay. No, I don't need anything else. Well, I do, but... I want the Hylian hood. That'll be 60 rupees. I'll take it. That's 2 defense more than what I'm wearing right now, and so is the tunic. And the legs probably are as well. Which means I'm gonna get a total of 6 more defense. Actually, I'm gonna get a total of 7 more defense because I don't even have a hood on right now. I only have trousers and like a chest piece. So... Plus... Now that I have this stuff, I guess technically I could sell the beginner's outfit, but I don't know if I want to really do that, because, like, I don't know, I might want it for transmog later, you know what I mean? I don't think there's actually transmog in this game. I know you can dye your outfits, though. Let me look at my map. I need to head off that way to, like, the east, but I also want to- I still haven't really figured out how this- The little thing that's beeping near my mini-map, that's supposed to tell me when I'm getting closer to a shrine. So I guess I just listen to it, and the faster it bleeps at me, the closer I'm getting. What is all of this? What is this? What is the point of all that? Can I bomb that? Let's try. No? That's so strange. Oh, there's a big tree. I bet you there's something up here in this tree. Come on, Link. Off there in the distance, you can actually see Hyrule Castle. The whole premise of this game is that 100 years ago, Ganon basically took over the kingdom, and Hyrule was at, like, its peak of technology, and so they created these, like, automaton robots called Guardians and, like, these big things called Divine Beasts that are basically machinery that are used as weapons, and Ganon somehow managed to take control of them, so they had to lock Ganon. Zelda is inside the castle. She's been in there apparently for 100 years, keeping him inside. So the goal of the game is to get inside there and defeat him and save her, but in order to make... You can technically go in there from the very beginning and fight him, but he's supposed to be like... I mean, he'll just one-shot you. So what you have to do is you have to go around and you have to find the Divine Beasts and get their power in order to make him weaker, essentially. So it's really cool because you can technically beat this game within like 15 minutes if you're amazing at video games. I'm jumping off here because off there in the distance, and I'm probably not going to make it before my stamina gauge runs out, so I'm going to try to land up here and get some of that back. There's a red thing over there. That is a shrine. That is what I have been looking for like ever now. There's 120 of them in Hyrule, and like I said, every 4 spirit orbs you get, you can choose whether or not to increase your health pool or your stamina meter. I chose to increase my stamina meter at first, but I'm thinking now that I'm finally getting to the point where I'm being one-shot by enemies, I probably should do the health. So let's jump off here and glide down, because I want to go to this shrine. Yeah, I know a shrine is close, I can see it. It is right there in front of me. I don't know, this tool is helpful, but the beep... Oh god, there's Lizalfos! Okay, hold the phone. Lizalfos are going to wreck me. They're gonna wreck me. I need to get in here, like, quickly, Link. Come on. I think Lizalfos will one-shot me at this point. I don't know! I just got the better armor, so... Maybe I would stand more of a chance, but I don't really want to wait around to find that out. So see you later! I'm going down. Hello to anyone who's joining in. I'm a little bit past Kakariko Village. I don't know where you guys are coming from or how much you know about the game. But basically, I'm just running around looking for shrines now. And just exploring in general. This is my, like, 6th or 7th shrine, I think. This is the shrine of Dakatus. So these are what I was talking about, though. These shrines are like little mini dungeons, and there's 120 of them around the world. And for completing it, you get a spirit orb, and every 4 spirit orbs you get to upgrade yourself. So, the idea, like, these things, I want to say they're probably magnetic. So let me try... Okay, they're not magnetic. Ooh, what is in... Ah, what is that? Oh, wow, okay. So maybe I have to scoop them up? Am I literally scooping these up with this bowl? Is that what's happening? Is that underneath? Yeah, there we go. Oh, come on. No, don't tip over. Damn it. Go in the water. How am I... I can't actually, like, I got one. All right, I got one. Oh, I see it. Can I, like... Yes, that's exactly what I have to do. Do I just need to do the one? Yes! Alright, that's really cool. That is awesome. I love, like, the puzzles are so creative. I'm enjoying it a lot. Now what do we do? In here there's more of those. What is that gonna be? That can't be magnetic, right? Yeah, that's not magnetic, so maybe the stasis rune? Yeah. What is stopping time gonna do with that, though? Hmm. I genuinely don't... Do I need to go... Okay, what this does is it freezes an object in time. And when it's done being frozen in time, any kinetic energy that... Like, so if I attack something with my sword that's been stored in time, as soon as the time freezing is up, the object will, like, propel in whatever direction I was hitting that item. But I don't really understand what to do here in particular. Maybe I go back and I, like, grab the... Oh no, can I not get it now that it's in there? Please. Wait, where is it? Oh, it's at the bottom. Okay. That's fine. Let's grab it again. Come on, lift that up. Lift. And let's take it on through. Nope, down. Thank you. Yeah, I don't understand. What am I meant to be doing here? Do I like put this on top of that? That doesn't make sense. Is this another scooping area? Like, am I just overthinking? I bet you I'm overthinking this. Let me try something. Let me just lift this up at... Oh. What? Well, it looks like this will open eventually, right? Come on. Dump that. Whatever. I don't understand. I don't understand what's going on. What else? What other objects do I even have? I've got bombs. Bombs are not gonna work through the water. I guarantee that. I don't know. Maybe. Maybe they work. Let's throw a bomb down there, I guess. Oh, they do work in the water! Okay. Let me try this, then. Stasis rune. Nope, stasis rune. There we go. I want to shoot that, and then I want to go back over to the bombs. I want to do these bombs, though. Nope. Is that gonna do anything at all? What the heck? I am very confused. This is the first shrine that I've legitimately been like, I don't know what I'm doing here. What is this? Like, it's not metal. And I don't know what I could possibly do to open it. Like, or to activate it. It's definitely interactable with the stasis rune. That much I know. But like... I would imagine that whatever I'm supposed to do to this thing, it opens up the top of that box over there, which then allows me to put the little orb inside, which will then activate the gate or whatever. But what is even supposed to open up to me when I do that? I don't see a gate to go through. I'm very, very confused. Is there anything at the bottom? No, nothing at the bottom there. Any ideas? Because I'm drawing a blank here. Can I just toss a bomb in there regularly? Maybe. Okay, hold on. Maybe. No, pick it up. Pick it up and toss it. Well, that's not where I wanted to toss it. I wanted to... No. Yep. Come on, charge back up. I want to toss it that way. Is it just gonna float there? It's just gonna float there. What? Maybe... No. Okay, I'm gonna do the stasis rune again. No. Stasis rune. Oh, wait. Oh. I can stasis rune other things, too. Why would I want to do that, though? Oh, wait a minute. I could, like, hammer that. Was that to, like, stop it from blowing up or something? Let me try that again. Yeah, that just, like, breaks it early. I didn't really want to do that. Wait a minute. Okay, I have an idea. I have one idea. Use the Magnesis rune. Looks like the thing in the water is a button to remove the water. Maybe. But I think I'm gonna try to scoop up one of these. Okay, no, wait, I want to get that out of there first, though. I want to get it out of there without it falling back in the water. Okay, there we go. Alright, I got that. Now, if I throw these in the water, will they sink to the bottom and hit that, maybe? My thought here is that I either stasis rune the ball and then, like, drop it into the water. Can I even pick it up when it's... No. I can do this, though. Like, this is what this does right here. So the ball's gonna now fling off in a direction, yeah. Maybe. Okay. This is gonna be tricky, but I think I can do it. Come on, go underneath. There we go. Now, come up. Am I not gonna be able to get it now? Come on, get out of the water! Oh man, I can't get that now. Alright, I'll get this one over here then. Why can I not? It's like too close to me now. Oh, maybe because I need to do that. Yeah. Okay. Lift. Damn it. Why is this so difficult? No, not you, Sheikah Slate. Damn it. If I can't figure this out in like 5 or 10 minutes, I might, I don't know, skip this dungeon, possibly. But I would like to figure it out. Come on, scoop that up. There we go. Okay, I don't have many chances to try this, apparently. Okay, so I don't even think I need that anymore. I think what I want to do is... I don't know, this still kind of doesn't make sense in my head how I'm gonna make this work. Okay, that won't roll, so I can put it, like, right at the edge. Now, what I'm thinking is if I stasis rune this... And then I go over here and I, like, hit it. No. There's no way. It's just not gonna work. Damn. Can I put this basin on, like, the thing? If this is the answer, I'm gonna be really annoyed. Oh, you're kidding me. Yep, that's what you do. Okay, but now, guess what? I need that thing again so that I can scoop up a ball and put it in there. That's maybe what she said, I don't know. But yeah, that's what I have to do. Am I gonna have to restart this dungeon because I can't get over there? Can I, like, push them out of the way while swimming? I don't know. Maybe that's why these, ladders exist. I just don't have a whole lot of stamina, so I'm a little bit afraid of doing this, but let's try anyway. Come on, push it, Link. Push it, push it, push it, push it. Good. Okay, no, don't push it back that way. Push it this way. Okay, that should be good. That should be good. Okay, now what I want to do, though, is I want to get the thing out first with my Magnesis rune. Yep, there we go. And I want to scoop this up. Am I under it? There we go. Okay. Oh no, don't, no, 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 no. Okay, wait. Drop that. Drop it. you get in there and stay in there, for God's sake. And now I'm gonna lift this, and this is gonna be tricky because this thing only stays open. Okay. No, there we go. Yes, that is what I wanted to do. Okay, now I should be able to. I can't see though. Is it over it? Yeah, there it is. Ta-da! All right. And that's gonna drain. Yeah, you were right about draining the water. Yep, that's right. Okay, so that was quite the freaking puzzle. I don't know why that was so hard for me to grasp. I guess I didn't think that the metal thing was gonna weigh the button down, but. And usually there's like a secret chest in all of these shrines, but I don't see one in this dungeon. And I'm pretty positive I didn't miss anything. So, let's go ahead and talk to this guy. So yeah, he's going to give us a spirit orb now, which I accidentally just skipped because I am impatient. And that's our seventh one total. We need one more now to have the four that we need to turn in to get a heart. Maybe because it's early simpler quest thus far. I mean, I don't know. This wasn't a particularly hard shrine. It's just for some reason I was overthinking the problem. I thought that I had to, like, you know, use kinetic buildup to, like, shoot a ball down to the bottom and, like, hit the button and... Uh-oh. Lizalfos. Okay, wait. I need to sneak up on this guy. No! I wanted to sneak up! Oh, these guys are fast. There's no way. There's no way I'm getting away from him. Yeah, there's no way. Well, maybe. I don't know. Oh, I'm so dead. I'm gonna be dead. Come on, Link. Just get away, just get away, just get away. I have a feeling Lizalfos are gonna kick my ass. Oh, he's fast. He is so fast. Why are you so fast? Come here. Is he gonna run away? Okay, he ran away. Good. Wow. The other nice thing about the shrines is once you complete them, they're like fast travel points, essentially. So now I can fast travel to that location anytime I want to. I'm gonna go ahead and pause this, and I'll be back in like 20 seconds, because I think I hear Rose. I have Rose in the other room, because she barks all day long, and she is so loud, and I love her, and I wish she could stay in the room and, like, actually be in the stream and stuff, but she screams all the time, but I think I hear her trying to, like, get out of her room, so I'll be back. Okay, I was wrong. Well, I wasn't wrong. It was definitely Rose I was hearing, but Bill came home, and I didn't even realize, and I feel terrible, but he came home, and he took the dog into the bedroom, so they're in there having cuddle time. Ooh, what is this? A well? Can I go in it? Why is that the first thing that I think to do when I see a well? It's not even that deep. What kind of well is that? Who makes a well that's, like, 2 foot deep? Oh my god, I see a Poe. I see a Poe. Oh my gosh. And I have a feeling I'm gonna get wrecked by it if I try to fight it, but I'm also kind of really curious. I have no arrows. Okay, maybe I'll leave that alone for now. Because I think it's gonna kick my ass if I try to go after it. Why? What are you doing? Why are you attacking me, Ram? I wasn't gonna... hurt you. I was gonna leave you alone, but if you're gonna be a jerk... is that another shrine all the way over there? I think it is. I want to go and find another shrine because I really want to start just doing as many shrines as I can, open up as many fast travel points as I can so that I can, you know, get around easier, but also so that I have more hearts so that I don't die as easily because I am, like, so... Wait, what? What? What are you? Come here. Come here. Wait, where did it go? Where did it go? Did I lose it? Aw, man. It was something I could collect. It was like a salamander. There's so many things in this game. I have no idea, like... Oh, you're a Lizalfos! Okay. I see you. Come on. I'm gonna fight you this time. I'm ready to take you... Oh, shit! Yes! Oh, wow! Oh, he's almost dead. Oh, no! Come on. Did I kill him? I killed him! Wow! Alright, what did he drop? Lizalfos horn. This winding horn once grew atop the head of a Lizalfos. It's too hard to use for cooking, but stores are willing to buy it from you. You can also use it to make elixirs. And Lizalfos talon, it was the elbow of a Lizalfos. You can stew it with critters to make elixirs, but it may have some other uses as well. And he dropped a new weapon. Lizzle spear, only 7 damage. That's weak. There's another one. Wait, no, I don't want to equip the tree branch, damn it. I want to equip the claymore, and I want to get rid of the tree branch, and I want to get rid of, like, well, maybe nothing right now. Oh my god, where did that one come from? Holy crap, there's 2 of them. There's 2 of them. I want to attack the weaker one, though. Come here. Come here, you. Oh, shit. Okay, it's not doing too much damage to me. Yes! Wow, my weapons are just breaking over and over again. Wow! I need new weapons. I need new weapons, I said! Okay, wow, all my weapons just broke. Lizzle spear? I guess I have to use it. I guess that's what being in the wilderness is all about. Hence why the game is called Breath of the Wild. But, wow. Just wow. They weren't that bad, though. I think my armor is really helping out a lot. I don't know how the game calculates... Oh, get away from me, Ram. I don't know how the game calculates damage, but... I'd imagine, like, maybe one bit of armor makes you take, like, half a heart less of damage or something, or a quarter of a heart less, I don't know. So, getting 7 more armor is obviously going to be a big boon to us. I just saw a shrine somewhere, and I've already lost track of it. Where was it? I need to get a horse again. This is such slow travel. I'm in an entirely new region. I'm not even supposed to be here yet, really. Really? There can't be only 2 shrines in this region. Like the other region that we were in. There has to be more than that, but I didn't see any. But I guess I'll head off this way. I mean, why not? I know there was a shrine in this general direction, I just don't remember where. Was it over here? Oh, I'm out of stamina. Wasn't paying attention. Oh, giant choo-choos! Nice, that's a lot of chew jelly. I wonder what the... choo-choo jelly is used for. I haven't really found a proper use for it yet. I see a fox over there. Oh, the thing is beeping, right? So that means shrine is nearby. Is it this direction? Ah, yeah, there it is. I knew it was over here somewhere. The beeping is a little annoying, but unfortunately if I don't have it on, then it's always a little bit harder to find shrines without it. What is that big thing? Can I climb up that? Oh. Oh, you there? What? Who? I'm over here! Oh, it's a Zora! Wow, I'm not supposed to have met Zori yet, because I'm... I don't know, I'm not supposed to go off in this region yet, I'm pretty sure. I apologize for calling you so calling on you so suddenly. I'm Lido, a proud member of the distinguished Zora. As you are a real Hylian, I had no choice but to call upon you. Will you please spare me a moment of your time? Sure. Sure. Thank you so much. Do you see that tower, the one atop that mountain yonder? I need you to go upstream of Zora River, which runs along the north side of that tower, to Inogo Bridge. I can see it in your eyes. You're asking yourself, why me? A reasonable question for a stranger accosted by passing Zora in such a manner. But I must assure you, this venture will be very profitable for you as well. You see, Prince Sidon of the Zora is in desperate search of a strong Hylian, and this is a royal request from the prince himself. It's safe to assume a generous reward is in the cards. That's why I'm asking you to meet with Prince Sidon at Inogo Bridge along the Zora River just upstream of here. Sure. I might not do that immediately, though, because I'm already on a quest. I'm already on a bunch of quests, actually, and I'm getting am I gonna be able to swim all the way there? Do I have enough stamina? Do I trust myself enough? You know what I can do to get a little bit further, maybe, is jump and paraglider. Okay. I believe in you, Link. I believe in you. Come on, you can make it. Oh, I see a Lizalfos over there. Damn it. I'm gonna have to deal with more of those guys. This also looks like it's covered in bramble. I wonder if that means I need fire arrows. That would be bad, because I am out of fire arrows, and oh man, I do, don't I? Is that what this is gonna be, like, burn the brambles to get inside? Can I slash at them? No. Okay, Lizalfos hasn't seen me yet, so I'm gonna go around. Oh man, I bet you that's what I have to do. Yeah, oh yeah, that's the entrance up there. Damn, and I don't have any arrows left, huh? No, not that. This. Oh, I don't have a bow equipped? Really? Where's my bow? Oh shit, Link! I pressed the whistle button, and so the Lizalfos heard me. Nope, not that button. Come on. You. Die. Stay dead! Oh, but give me everything that you dropped, please. Come on. Go get it. Go get it, Link. Alright. Back onto the mainland. Alright, and I want to grab his weapon. Spiked Boko Spear. Why is he dropping me a Boko Spear? He's not a Bokoblin. Ooh, what is this? Chickaloo Tree Nut. Small birds love this nut. You can eat it raw for a minor effect, but it can be added as a spice for other recipes. Okay, good to know. And yeah, it does look like I need some sort of fire effect to burn down all these brambles. I'm gonna kill this Lizalfos, though. I wanna see if I can sneak up on him. Come on, Link. Be quiet, be sneaky. And why? Oh shit, okay, well. I had to look down to see what button Y was. I'm still not 100% used to the controls yet of the Switch. So, oh, stop going in the water. Alright, there we go. Got all his stuff. Yes, I know there's a shrine nearby. I can see it. Ooh, spiked Boko bow. That's really nice. No, not that. Yes, that is. Okay, so I already have it equipped. Is that what I am to believe? Yeah. Yeah, I need fire arrows. Shoot. I wish I had fire arrows, but I don't. I used them all on those bokoblins, and then I ended up not even being able to clear the camp without dying. So, I collect these. I need to get back on track a little bit, I think. And I can't go from there to Kakariko Village, so I guess I need to go back to the tower. Which is fine. I really like the teleporting effect in this game. It's really cool looking. Yeah, I like the spear. The spear seems to be good because it allows me to attack from, like, a distance, but still with a melee weapon. So yeah, it's I think it's a pretty good weapon. I'm doing better with it than I was the other stuff. Okay, we're back on the tower now. But I need to like, where do I want to go from here? I mean, I no, stop whistling, Link. That just got us into a lot of trouble. I want to go back up. I guess probably should just head in that direction. I got some new armor, so it's not like I'm hurting for anything. I should go back. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to go back to Kakariko Village, which I what is beeping? The thing is beeping, but there's no shrines nearby. I just heard it beep. I know I'm not crazy. I just heard it beep, but I don't see any shrines anywhere. All right, whatever. Let's jump off and glide this way. I need to find a horse. I need some fast travel in my life. But I don't know if I'm gonna find any around here. There's like a big tree over here. I wonder if that's got anything on top of it. Oh, this is that dumb encampment with all those bokoblins that like killed me a million times. Yeah, I think there's probably something up here, so I want to climb up this and check it. Oh wait, didn't I find a bird's nest in here? Or was that in the other area? That might have been. Yeah, that was in the other area. There's nothing in the tree though. No. Well, if at any rate, I can use it to glide a little bit. Kakariko Village is like northeast of here, but I haven't really explored much of this area, I don't think. Is there another? There's no shrine. Like, I don't hear any beeping. My thing is not going off telling me that there's any shrines, like, within the area. And that's really frustrating, because, like, this region of Hyrule only has two shrines? Like, that can't be right. But I need to go back to town anyway. I need to cook a bunch of food, and I need to buy some more arrows, because I like. The ranged combat is really nice. But it's very like resource heavy, and arrows are not exactly the most plentiful thing to come by. You get them in like batches of five and not very frequently, so. Is there anything interesting in here? This looks kind of, I don't know, suspicious. I guess not. Well, there's the bridge that we need to cross. Are there any horses nearby? I'd love a horse right now, game. That would be nice. No, but I see some geese, and I see some birds that are gonna give me some trouble. Oh, what the hell was that? What was that? I'm scared. I don't know what that was, but wait, what? What was it? Wait, I just saw something over here. What? What was that? I'm gonna turn around again and it's gonna happen again. Watch. Ah, there it is! Come here, you! It's like a plant. Oh, it's an octorok, right? That's what they're called. Octoballoon. This inflatable octorok organ has a lot of lifts, so attach it to items you want to see float. Hold it in your hands and then place it on an object to attach it? Why would I want to make an item float? Or, oh, maybe just an object in general. Maybe that'll be used to like solve puzzles and stuff. That's interesting. There is a shrine over there, but that one's blue because I've already been in it. Oh, I see one like all the way over there. Is that even still in this region? No. Oh, but I want it. I kind of want it. All right. All right, I'm getting sidetracked one more time before we go back to the village because I really, 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 really want another unit of health. And hold on. Oh wait, no, that's not an enemy. That's a guy. I was gonna attack him and steal his horse, but he's a friendly guy. We've already talked to him before, so I don't need to talk to him again. Oh my gosh, this bokoblin's like attacking this civilian. Figures there'd be monsters hanging around this exact day I come to look out at the river. Hey, leave that person alone, bokoblin, you jerk. Wait, do I get anything for helping you? Any rewards, maybe? Whew. I was nervous for a minute there. Thanks for the help. Nice! Mighty Fried Bananas. Grants a low-level attack power boost. Children love fried Mighty Bananas. The trick is frying them over very high heat. I like watching the river flow by. Is that such a crime? Seeing the water stream so peacefully makes it hard to believe the great calamity really happened. The monsters attack out of nowhere, and I think, oh right, time to head back to the stables. Ugh, whatever. Yeah, this world is in disarray. Ganon basically destroyed everything. This is literally post-apocalyptic Hyrule, which is a really cool concept for a game. Yeah, I don't really care about you guys that much. I want to go to the shrine, which is off in this direction. Whoa, are those keys? Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. You're kidding me. You're kidding me right now. You are kidding me right now. You are kidding me. Oh my god. Oh my god. I'm terrified. I hate this. I hate this. Okay. Are they? Oh, I missed. Get away from me. This is horrifying. What is happening? Okay. No, not the Sheikah Slate. Damn it. Sheikah Slate. Take a hint, Sheikah Slate. Oh, okay. I'm ready for you. Come on, come back. Come back. Oh no, they're leaving. That was single-handedly the most terrifying experience so far. Holy shit. I was like, oh, look at those birds. Nope, it's a bunch of bats. Man-eating, vicious bats. Oh wow, Wago Kata Shrine. But there also looks to be, like, a village nearby, so I'll have to check that out after the shrine, but I want to go in the shrine first. Holy my gosh, can you believe that? That's insane. I bet you if I could throw a bomb into the group of them without, you know, screaming and running away like a little girl and missing all the time, I bet you I could kill them. And I bet you that there'd be, like, a lot of rewards for killing that many keys. The load screens kind of kill me. They're not too terrible, but just having them in general is, you know, you don't normally have to worry about load screens in Zelda games. Oh, this is a very, oh wow, I can already see the end right there. He's up there, but how do I get up there? Wago Kata is this guy's name. Metal Connections is what this one is called. Can I climb up those, or are they just metal? I can climb up them. Oh, you know what? I bet you anything that I move these with the Magnesis Rune. But there's a chest up here first, so I'm gonna grab it. Okay, I got an amber out of that. That's nice. I still don't know what those are used for. Probably crafting. But yeah, I think... This is a really simple... Is this really that simple? I guess it is. Alright, Magnesis Rune. Oops, I dropped the bomb. Oh well. Can I, like, pick all of them up and move them? Yeah. Well, I'm kind of cheating the system a little bit here. And I don't care. I don't care that I am cheating the system. If I'm... Okay, I get it. Alright. Let's just very, very slowly push it. Alright, there we go. That can stay there, and now I need to, like, even these out. That'll save me a bunch of time, I think. Yeah, that'll definitely save me a bunch of time. And the last one. No, the last one, I say. Alright, I should be able to climb up from this direction. The physics in this game and the fact that it actually works like this just amazes me. I'm like, I love this. This is so cool. I probably have to make a bridge with this thing. That would be my guess. But how? I'm thinking of how I could do this. Damn it. And there's no more blocks, huh? I mean, I could do this, just, you know, like, make a... It probably won't stay once I let it go, though. Yeah, it's not gonna stay. So, what I think I need to do is maybe grab these, like, one by one, and move them over here. I need to get that other thing back, too. Can I have you back? Oh, okay. Alright, there we go. I just want to put it up here for a second. No, uplink. Up. There we go, drop it. And can I even get this from here? Probably. Yeah. Let's try to pick both of these up again. I don't know. This doesn't... Yeah, it doesn't really seem to save that much time, so... lift. And drop. Okay, I think I get it. I think I get what I need to do. I need to make this into a taller thing. So, like this. Is that on top? Is that about right? Yeah, that's good enough. Maybe we can, because physics is gonna take its toll, let's, like, move this over slightly. Yeah. Okay, right about there. Now, I want to take the bottom block, I think. God, I hope this works. And I want to just, like, scoot the whole... No! Your kit... Oh, alright. Damn it. I cannot leave the top of this platform or I won't be able to do what I want to do. So, let me just try to move. I'll do this one at a time again. Just really try to, like, stretch this out, maybe. And drop it. That's really not that much further than I had it. I'm so annoyed. Lift. And... drop. No. Wow. I had it, too. Like, I should have just left it alone and tried it before I, like... Push-pull. Push-pull. Yeah. I need to stretch... I need to, like, stretch that out as far as I can possibly get it. And I can't see a damn thing. I don't know why I'm trying to, like, look over it as if that's gonna help. Is that about right? No. I need to pull it back more. Come on. Pull it back more. Like, right there? No. Okay, well, that's closer, though. I'll take it. Because maybe I can get a better angle on it. Yep, there we go. Okay, that's good. Now, I need to not knock these... Oh, please! No, game! Are you kidding me right now? Are you kidding me right now? Oh, you're not kidding me right now. Can I get on this and move it? Wouldn't that be weird? No, that doesn't make sense because I don't have a center of gravity for myself. Oh, what I could probably do though, I didn't really want to have to jump down here to do this, but I will if I have to. And like, can you turn the correct way? There we go. Maybe angle this one a little bit more. There. Okay. Come on. Lift you all the way up. Is that about center? Yeah. Okay. I should be able to climb these now. And maybe I can get back up to the top of this thing just by gliding over. That's my hope anyway. Cause what I think you're supposed to do, you're supposed to put these kind of in the middle, and then you're supposed to put this longer platform as like almost a bridge up. Oh, can I not make it? Son of a bitch. Alright. I need to move these just like slightly closer. I know that this'll work. I know it'll work. It's just really hard and finicky because the physics are physics. Like this game has a pretty decent physics engine. So if you ever played Gmod or anything like that, that's essentially what you're dealing with. Link, why won't you climb up that wall? Maybe I might... Okay, I think I know what I could do to make this a little bit easier to get across. I could grab this with the magnesis rune. Come on, why isn't it... What? Pull, thank you. Jeez. Oh, no. Of course you're not gonna let me do that. Well, I'm gonna try to scoot it inch by inch then. Really? Are you not gonna move any further than that? You're really not going to move any further than that. Okay, I'm gonna try to make the jump one more time, and then I might have to just... Oh, I failed that. Well, alright, come here. Damn it. Just get closer. Thank you. Alright. If this is not close enough, I might cry. Come on, Link, climb. Climb faster. Alright, now we can jump across. There we go. Now I want to very, very, very carefully, slide these. Okay. Well, I officially am angry. All right, one more time. I know that this will work. Why are these shrines so, like, it's the physics engine that's just driving me nuts here. Drop that there. Come on, Magnesis rune. This is, like, the coolest rune, I think, in concept, but it's so finicky. Thank God Link's own, like, body weight doesn't make these topple over, because that would just be obnoxious. Alright, I'm gonna do... I'm just gonna try this now. Maybe this is enough. I feel like this is not going to be far enough. In fact, how... Just how? Because no matter what I do with this thing... drop, please. Yep. I'm kind of, like, just in disbelief right now, as to what just happened to me. I know what happened to me! I dropped the fucking thing on my head, and it killed me. And yeah, it looks like I don't have enough parts, but, like, how else would I get up here? I know that you can make a bridge with these damn things. I know you can. Like, I know you can. Ugh. Alright, I'm gonna start from square one here. I have already collected the chest up there. It's not gonna make me collect the chest again, so that's good news. I might need to even, like, I don't know. No, not the bombs. Go away, bombs. Magnesis rune. Okay. Let's just slide these over very carefully. Very carefully. I don't want to have to do these one by one. I need to get up here. Oh no. Oh shit! Run! How? Did that not kill me? That didn't kill me. The physics of this game actually kills you. That's insane to me. I mean, this is such a new concept for a Zelda game. Wow. Just wow. Just wow. Like, I'm kind of, you know, part of me is mad. Part of me is mad. I'm not gonna lie. Part of me is frustrated. But part of me is also just laughing on the inside, because it's amazing that this works this way. Like, the physics actually can kill you. Come on, grab that. And the other thing too is, like, these puzzles have different ways of being solved. Like, maybe the way I'm trying to solve this is only one way of solving it. Maybe I'm not even doing this correctly. In fact, I'm probably not doing this correctly, because it's me and I overthink every situation. Why did you just make a jingle there as if I solved a puzzle? I didn't solve any puzzle. No puzzles have been solved yet. Do you see this? I have not solved a puzzle game. Now, I'm not gonna drop this on my head, though, this time, hopefully. I want to grab it from this angle. I want to lift it up very carefully. And I want to kind of, like, I want to place it like so. Please stay. Please stay. Okay. Now that I've done that... Hold on. I can salvage this. I can salvage this. I believe in myself. Yeah. Yep. Right there. Okay. Okay. Now just don't topple over on me, and we're gonna be okay. Gonna be okay. Come on, Link. Climb up faster. Use that stamina. That's why I upgraded it. Now, the concept here is that I should be able to make a bridge, right? Like, I should be able to get over with this thing, but, like, how? I could use the kinesis rune, not the kinesis, the stasis rune. Okay, let me think about how I need to do this. Alright, I think this is gonna work. I think I understand what I need to do. I need to do this. I need to stop time. I need to quickly pull out a remote bomb. I need to put it down. Oh, no, 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 no. No, roll over there, blow up. And then hopefully, is this gonna work? Well, that's the concept, though. That is the concept, like, that's essentially what I want to do. You know what? Hold on, not bombs. Maybe now that I have this down, let me try this. I'll slide these over, like to, I don't know, there or something. And then, yeah, this is kind of what I want to do. As long as these don't topple over, as long as I have a little bit of room to do that, will this work? I'm gonna put it down, see what it does. It slides right off and ruins everything again. Damn it. I don't know. What else could I do? I'm so confused. Am I missing a component here? It doesn't look like it. I don't see anything else. Wait, what is that? Can I do something with that? No? The only thing that I can really think of is that I need to stack them all up again and probably stop time on this platform right here and then attack it a bunch of times so that it jettisons across, but like, it still wouldn't make it all the way up to the top because it's not tall enough. It's just not tall enough to be up there. Maybe... Okay, I'm gonna try one more thing. One more thing. I keep saying one more thing, but then I keep thinking of one more thing that I can do. Okay. I have to say, I'm a big fan of this. Like, the fact that the puzzles are not exactly straightforward and the fact that they can be solved by, like, you know, if I place this, right, so I have a little bit of room to kind of climb up and a little bit of room for it to not fall, but also to get me more across. I'm gonna lift this, and I wanna kind of like, I wanna drop it like right there. Please stay, just stay there. Okay. I wanna see what I can get away with here. I think that this is gonna topple. And I really don't want it to, but I think it's going to. Can I place this, like, up here and then... Oh, do you see it? Do you see it happening? Okay, wait. I get it. Ooh, don't die! Oh, get away from it! Jesus Christ! I've never been more afraid of, like, falling metal in my life. Okay. I need to do this very, very carefully. Because I need a little bit more room. Is that close enough? I think that's close enough. Sure. Okay. Okay, I think that might work! I think I might have done it! Can I get up now? You let me up? Please don't topple. That's like... The only thing I ask of you is don't topple on me. Yes! Oh my god! I did it. Wow. What a puzzle. I like it because the answer wasn't very straightforward. Like, I had to make it so that the things were kind of like in a stair shape so that I could get further across so that the platform could reach, and... Yeah, wow. Just wow. Nice hat, by the way, guy. Yeah, so that's what it looks like when we get a spirit orb. We literally absorb it into our chest. And we finally have four, so I can update stuff now, or upgrade myself. And by the way, Blue, you can leave at any time. I won't feel bad about it. People have been kind of popping in and out all day, so don't feel like if you leave me alone in the stream that I'm going to be, like, sad or anything. Because I will find a way to keep myself entertained. I'm mostly doing this, like, to kind of, you know, let people know about my YouTube channel. I'm doing another Zelda game on my YouTube channel. I have, like, 9 episodes as of today up of that, so... this is my stream, and then the YouTube channel is a different Zelda game, but... kind of using them to supplement each other. And this is Beetle. This is, like, he's a famous NPC in all the Zelda games, pretty much. Hey, I don't believe I made your acquaintance! My name's Beetle, but you can call me... Actually, let's just stick with Beetle. But... Oh, you're dungeoning as you watch. But even if you forget my face, you can remember me by my beetle-shaped backpack. Despite these dangerous times, you'll find me traveling all over Hyrule to fulfill your shopping needs. I stock many special bugs and always have items for travelers, and I always charge a fair price, or my name's not Beetle. I also buy all sorts of things. If you're in need of rupees, gemstones in particular, fetch a high price. How can I help you today? Well, what have you got? Oh, wow, he sells 20 arrows for 6 rupees? Wait, is that per arrow? Yeah, that's per arrow. I think I can get 5 arrows in Kakariko Village for 20 rupees, so that's kind of actually really expensive. He sells Thunderwing Butterflies, which can be made into elixirs for electricity resistance. And Timeless Frogs for temporary stamina boosts, but I don't know if I care about that. Does he buy anything that I own for, like, a better price? I think opals back in Kakariko were 60, yeah, and he still buys them for that, so that looks like those prices stay relatively the same. I don't know. I don't know what I want to do. I guess I don't really care enough to sell stuff, because I haven't found anything that I want to buy immediately, except for more arrows. What do you do? Hello? Talk. Oh. Ember. Welcome, will you be staying with us? Oh no, this is an inn. Yeah, I don't need to stay at an inn right now. Yeah. Have you gone to the giant castle north of here? That's Hyrule Castle. It's said to have fallen to ruin over 100 years ago. Honey, you don't see giant Calamity Ganon flying around in the air over Hyrule Castle? Like, it's not said to have fallen into ruins. It very clearly is in ruins, and there's a giant dark beast flying all over the place. Like, this girl's delirious. I used to sneak in there. You used to sneak in there to salvage ancient treasures, but it's too dangerous to go in there now. These days it's surrounded by an eerie mist and savage machine-like creatures. Oh boy. And I went in looking for this ultra-rare equipment that once belonged to the Royal Guard. It's legendary among collectors, but I was never able to find any. So there's obviously some really good treasure in there, but there's no way! There's no way I'm gonna be able to get in there with my gear right now. I have really crappy gear. I would die in like a split second.
Hi.
Hi. A customer. Are you traveling alone? The inn gets full marks for beauty, so I highly recommend taking a rest here. The river here makes for some lovely scenery, and if you head northwest from here, you'll find Millennio Sandbar. The scenery there is every bit as lovely as the scenery here. I'm something of a connoisseur of beauty, you see. I simply cannot resist a beautiful sight. I try to exclude this in all things, not least of all my own beautiful appearance. Speaking of, has anyone ever told you you have the most beautiful features? Are you hitting on me, guy? I mean, that's fine, but... I do have many fond memories of this beautiful land. If you have the time, would you indulge me? I guess. Do I get anything out of listening to you? Oh, you would? Even more beautiful on the inside. I feel like a jerk after saying what I just said. If you head north through Hyrule Field, you'll see a castle surrounded by that foul aura. It has long been a den of monsters, but in its glory days, it was surely a thing of wondrous beauty. It was in that very castle in those very days that my ancestor... My grandfather's grandfather, I believe. Anyway, he worked as the castle's appointed chef. I couldn't believe it myself. Oh, I wonder what sorts of cuisine members of the royal court enjoyed in those good old days. As a child, I would often suffer meager meals, all while dreaming of the beautiful dishes that might have graced my plate. Oh, if only things had been different. Gourmet spiced meat, seafood curry, mushroom risotto, egg pudding. Oh my, I think I'm salivating, and it's my pursuit of those childhood dreams that explains the fabulous body you see here. Okay, whatever you say. These days I enjoy my time working at these stables, sharing my tales of beauty with any traveler willing to listen. But still, I wonder what could have been. Anyway, excuse me, I seem to have been caught myself prattling on, but look at your perfectly symmetrical face and disgusting meals of beauty has rekindled my desire. If you should happen to set foot inside Hyrule Castle, could you find it in you to keep an eye out for a cookbook? There must be one lying around somewhere in there. I'm simply dying to finally sample the food of the royal court. Oh, so we have another side quest. Nice. So this is like side quest. Oh my gosh, and we can sit down and cook here. I need to cook some food. So I've been told that if you like combine like meat and like monster parts, stuff happens, like good stuff. So let's do that. Let's see what a key swing and like a drumstick make. Dubious food? It's too gross to even look at. Really? That wasn't a good combination? I was lied to. Man. Okay, well, damn it. All right, well, let's try... When cooked into a dish, a big hearty radish, Hylian shroom, rushroom, cook it before eating to temporarily increase my movement speed. I should cook like one of these just to see what it does. Hasty mushroom skewer, 1 heart, 1 minute of speed increase. Okay. That's kind of nice. Let's do, like, can I make a, like, fish stew or something? Or maybe, like, let's do... Let's see what a Hyrule bass and a fortified pumpkin and, like, I don't know, a Hylian shroom make. I'm just spitballing here. I have no idea what this stuff is gonna do, but let's try it. Tough steamed fish, 4 hearts of healing, and increases my defense by a low amount. Wow, that's nice. This is more like it. Okay, let's try like a raw drumstick and an apple and a Hylian shroom. Why not? I could look up a guide. I'm sure there's like Wikia information that have, wow, meat and mushroom skewer, 4 hearts. So that's just a lot of hearts, which is really nice. Choo-choo jelly. I can't do anything with the choo-choo jelly yet. I can make an elixir with bokoblin horns. I wonder if I mix like a rush shroom with like a hillian shroom with like a stemella shroom. Why not? Oh wait, is this another type of mushroom? And a silent shroom. I am going to make a 4 shroom dish. I wonder if I should put meat in it too. Should I put meat in it? And maybe just like another hillian shroom? Why not? This is probably going to be a monstrosity, but let's see. Oh, something interesting is happening. Holy shit! 8 hearts? Copious mushroom skewers. 8 hearts. I have 3 hearts. That's not even going to be, like, used to its fullest potential for a really long time. That's crazy. Holy mother of God. Let's try different types of meat. Put like a drumstick and like raw meat and like, I don't know. Do I have another type of meat? I have a fish. Sure. Let's do a fish. Is that all I want to do? Yeah. Let's try it. Why not? It's probably going to be horrible, but we'll see. Oh, it made something. 6 hearts of healing, low level attack power boost. That's awesome. I love this. I love the cooking in this game. Now let's just try like two, let's try those meats. Why not? Let's just try those two. I want to see if this makes anything good with just the bird leg and the regular raw meat. Meat skewer, nice. So it's just 4 hearts. So I go from having 2 items that restore 2 hearts to having 1 item that restores 4 hearts. That seems like a pretty good deal to me. Let's combine those two and let's do like an apple and a hillian shroom and like, I don't know, a swift carrot. I love the cooking in this game, the little sound effect that it makes. Link like hums along to it. 7 hearts. 3 minutes of mid-level movement speed. That's awesome. Okay, I heard that you can combine monster parts, like, mix it with critters to make something useful. So, like, does a critter mean, like, a bug? Or, like, an animal? It shouldn't mean an animal, right? I mean, you'd think so, but... what is considered a critter? That's what I want to know. What does the bokoblin guts do? Perhaps it has a use. I don't know. Nightshade. Let's try to make something with stealth. Let's do, like, raw meat and a hylian shroom and, like, the nightshade. Nightshade is supposed to be poisonous. I don't know why you'd want to bake it into a meal. Sneaky steamed meat grants a low level stealth boost for 3 minutes and 3 hearts. That's nice. Okay. I'm running out of some stuff to... I'm running out of like meats and things, but that's fine. Let's do a hylian shroom, a drumstick, or no, sorry, raw meat, drumstick, hylian shroom, and... something that increases defense. Let's do an iron shroom. How about that? This should make something good. Tough meat skewer grants low level defense boost. Okay, cool. Only got a couple more meats left. Let's try like one meat and the big hearty radish and maybe like a bunch of apples. Sure, why not? Ooh, this one sounds like it's gonna be good. Holy mother of God, I just hit the jackpot. Full recovery restores your health and temporarily increases your maximum hearts by 6. Jesus Christ. Oh, that is far and away the best thing. And I think that had more to do with the fact that I had that turnip than anything else, because the turnip on its own healed for 4 hearts. Okay, I've got one more meat. Let's do, like, a drumstick, a bird egg, a Hylian shroom. What does a bird egg do? Perfect for cooking. Doesn't actually add anything interesting, though. I can add it. I can add stuff as, like, a spice. Temporarily increasing defense. Let's add an armored carp and, like, a chickaloo tree nut. This will be an interesting one if it actually works. Made something. 8 hearts of recovery, tough meat and seafood fry grants low level defense boost. Nice, for 4 minutes. Alright, so I think that's enough cooking for right now. I got all the cooking. Like, look at the food, the prepared food that we have. We have so much of it now. That's awesome. I shouldn't be in trouble of dying anytime soon unless I get one shot by something. I still need arrows, though. I didn't really want to have to buy them from Beetle. But unfortunately, it's either that or I go all the way back to freaking Kakariko Village. Which I guess is fine. I mean, I could teleport to this shrine and it wouldn't be that far away. Let's do that. I want to go back to Kakariko because Kakariko had a better deal on arrows, and I really, really want arrows. Plus, we have to go through this way anyway to get to the next area. Thermal baths are found throughout the world. You can relax in them for a while to replenish your hearts. Nice. Oh no, I remember this one. If you step on the flowers, the lady here gets pissed. And if you step on them too many times, she, like, attacks you and you take a lot of damage. And you're supposed to start from out here and go in there, but I already did this shrine, so I just step on the flowers anyway so that she, like, purposefully kicks me out so that I don't have to, like, go through the stupid flower maze again. But I want to go this way. I need to head up this rocky alcove or whatever. Grab an iron shroom there, that's nice. Iron shrooms are like defense, I guess, so picking that up is definitely useful for more cooking. Come on, Link, climb up. You can do it. I believe in you. Alright, so I'm heading in the right direction. There should be a bridge over here. I don't have a horse, though. I wish I had a horse. In fact, I might have a lot of trouble getting to Kakariko Village without a horse, because there are going to be bokoblins riding horses along the way. But, I mean, I wish there was a way to, like, call a horse. What did that do? There's, like, a piano playing. I don't know. I thought maybe that would, like, call my horse to me, but apparently it didn't. That's fine. I have had 2 horses. I haven't stabled them. Maybe if I stable horses, they'll come to me when called. I don't know. That would be nice, but I feel like I'm a little hopeful for thinking that. There's a ram over here. I just kind of want to avoid it though right now. I mean, I could always use some more raw meat, but I don't really have any arrows right now, and that's, like, the easiest way to kill those, so. Come on, Link. You can do it. You can do it. I mean, part of me really kind of wants more stamina, because stamina's really awesome to have, and I hate running out of it, but I know that if I don't spend my next upgrade on hearts, I'm probably going to regret it in the long run, because things just hit so hard. Oh, yeah, and you jerks are gonna follow me on the damn horses now. Ugh. Why? Just leave me alone. Just just keep running, just keep running, just keep running, running, running. Is he gonna leave me alone? Did he already go away? Maybe he already went away. Oh, horses! Okay, I need to sneak up on these because I think these ones will run away. Come on, horsey. Oh no, don't start walking away from me. The choo-choos, damn it! Oh, get on the horse, and soothe it, soothe it, soothe it, soothe the horse, soothe it, soothe it. I said soothe. No, Link, you did a very bad job of soothing that horse. Damn it, Link. Oh, he's still over here, come on. Horsey, come back, horse. By the time I catch up to you, you're gonna already be at the village. Come here. Come on, come on. Climb on him. Come on, soothe. Soothe. Oh, wow. This horse is, like, stubborn. Wow. Well, I have news for you, horse. You're running yourself into a dead end, so I will tame you eventually. Come here. Come on, pony. Come on, come on. Nope, nope, nope. Come back here. You're so fast. And obviously, I shouldn't be able to run faster than a horse. Come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. L, 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 L. I'm pressing L. Do I need more, like, energy to do it? I bet you I do. Come on, 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 do, 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 do it, do it, do it, do it, do it. Alright, I apparently just don't have enough energy, or stamina, rather, to soothe this horse. I think I need, like, at least a full stamina bar. Come here, come on. Yeah, like, I just have to press this over and over and over and over and over, and over. Yeah, it takes my stamina to press soothe, but it's not letting me actually soothe the horse, so that must mean that I need a certain level of stamina bar. Oh, and here's my other horse. He's where I left him. You're a good horse. You don't buck me off of you. Alright, back in Kakariko Village, finally. I want to go... What shop is this? Curious Quiver. Yeah, this is it. That doesn't look like a quiver on that sign. That looks like a potion or something. Oh, they have fire arrows. I kind of want to pick up some of these, but they're so expensive. Ooh, she has a quest. That's right, my good man. I knew the moment I saw ya. I had you figured out for one heck of an archer, and I'm head over heels for a fine slice of man that can use a bow. So how about it? Why not take out that bow and show me something special? Sure. I like your attitude. All you gotta do is light the torches by the goddess statue. Think you're up for a challenge? Goddess statue? You don't know about the goddess statue? It's by the spring in front of Lady Impa's home. I don't know who put it there, but it's always been there forever. So that's another goddess statue that we can pray to. The other one was at, like, the Temple of Time, way back in the beginning area. So that's good that we can pray to a new statue and don't have to go all the way back there. The thought of a young hunk drawing a bow just makes my day. Alright, lady, calm down. She wants me to light the thing, so that must mean that I need... That must mean that I need fire arrows. So I need to sell some stuff. You know what? I have a bunch of amber, and I know it's probably used in crafting, but I think I can sell, like... Yeah, that's fine. Sell that. I just don't want to sell that opal, because it's, like, the only one I have. I have a shit ton of bokoblin horns, but I also, like, I don't know, maybe I can sell, like, 15 of these or something. I'll still have... Yeah, I'll still have, like, 35 of them. Oh, no, not all of them. No. No, not all of them. Did I say all of them? I said... No, not one. Damn it. Okay. I want to sell... 15. Ah, okay, I understand what I did. 15, 45 rupees. Sure. Is there anything that I have that's worth anything at all? Yeah, I mean, obviously the opal is worth something, but it's the only one I have, and I don't really know what it's used for yet, so I don't want to get rid of it. The Lizalfos talons are kind of nice, but again, I'm not really in a whole, I'm a kind of a short supply of those. Let's do, like, 10 bokoblin fangs. So that'll get me another 80. Alright, I think I'm good now. I want to get, like... I don't know, maybe 5 of these arrows. So that's 1 arrow for 20 or 5 for 80. So you get a 20 rupee discount if you buy them in batches of 5. So that's nice. I also want to buy I want to buy like Why can I only buy two? Wait, what? Two of those is only 40 rupees. I have 241 rupees. Can I not carry anymore? Is that why? Oh, she's out of stock. Really? Oh, in inventory. Wait, is that... Does that mean her inventory? Oh, that's interesting. Alright, well, maybe if I need more fire arrows, I'll come back here for fire arrows, but... For now, I think that's all I need for arrows. I need to go find this goddess statue and light the torches that she was talking about, because I want whatever she's gonna give me for that. Ah, okay, so here's this. Ah, the torches are back here. So there's five of them, or there's four of them, rather. No, Link, get back up there. Link, what are you doing? Get out of the pond. Now is not the time. There's a time and a place for everything, and now is not it. I want different arrows. I want my fire arrows. Okay. Motion controls, work with me, please. Did I do it? Is that it? Why is that one, like, still crazy? Okay. While I'm here, I may as well pray to her. Why is she wearing a bib? Is that a bib? Like, what is... Why is the statue wearing a bib? Yeah, we're doing a heart container now. Yes, another heart container, please. I shall grant the power you seek. Nice. I like that they're still using the design of the heart containers from Skyward Sword. They were pretty cool looking. Increase my maximum number of hearts by one. That's pretty nice, especially since a lot of my food gives me, like, more than three or four hearts now. So I won't waste it as much if I have to eat any of it. But let's go back here, because now that I've lit the torches, she should be happy with me, right? Maybe she'll give me, like, a bigger quiver or something, or, I don't know, a discount. Hey, kid, I saw you. You were amazing. Boy, what a shot in the heart that was. My husband's a fine archer himself, but we're living apart right now. Uh-oh. Rocky marriage, huh? This feeling, it's been so, so long. I'm so... That really was something special to see. In fact, here, a token of my thanks. I feel bad for her. She gave me 20 rupees? If only my husband hadn't become obsessed with cuckoos and had kept up with his archery skills, if only. She gave me 20 rupees for lighting four torches that cost, like, 60 rupees to light. Are you kidding me, lady? You have got to be kidding me. This better be part of, like, a quest chain that gives me a better reward later on, because that is not... How does that calculate out in your mind, 20 rupees for four fire arrows? I mean, my god. Yeah, the shrine thingy is, like, beeping again. But it's not gonna show me on my map until I actually head off into the direction of, you know, like, an actual shrine. Ooh, there's apples in here. Sure, I'll take them. I'll take free apples. Is there anything else in the village that I want to, like, check out? I guess not. Sure, I will... how do I head out of here? Is this... This isn't the path. I think I went back here before, and it was, like... I don't know, it was like a cliff edge, and it brought me into the, yeah, it brought me into the other region, and I don't want to go into the other region. So maybe I go back up here? I don't know, like, I honestly don't know where I'm supposed to go. I guess back up here, there might be a passageway up at the top of the village. I love this village, it is so pretty. Ooh, you have a quest, you have a side quest. Kato, Sir Link, my cuckoos. Oh, is this her husband? My precious cuckoos. They haven't come home yet. Now that my wife wants nothing to do with me, my cuckoos are my only emotional support. Oh, what do I do? Oh, he's so mad. I'll go find them. Really? Thank you so much. I have 10 cuckoos total. Hopefully you'll be able to find them all. Oh my gosh, this is just like Ocarina of Time in Kakariko Village. This is really what that is. It's like a throwback to Ocarina of Time. Here's one. I like the cuckoos in this game, they're really cool looking. Like, blue and red. Okay, do I just throw him in? Oh, no, no, no. Pick him up, pick him up, pick him up. R is... No. Wait, what? Pick up. R is throw. Did that work? Only four have returned to me. So there's six... Okay, so there's only six that I need to collect. Because now there's four in the pen. So it is keeping track. Apparently I just have to toss them in there, but... There's gotta be six more cuckoos around this village. Are there any up here? Yeah, there's one up here. Can I toss him from up here? I don't want to have to go all the way back down there. Oh, that's risky, isn't it? That's so risky. I found the shrine that's been freaking beeping this whole time! Oh, and yeah, you can use cuckoos to float, just like in other games. That's really awesome. I want to toss you in there. Get in there, cuckoo. If I enter the shrine, am I going to have to do all the... Maybe I should do the cuckoos before I go into the shrine. In fact, yeah, I think that's what I'm going to do, because I don't want to lose progress on this side quest. Got three, so I should only need, like, four more after this. I think... Oh, cuckoos. They're kind of the bane of my existence. Anyone who's watching my Twilight Princess Let's Play in the future will know exactly what I mean by that. There's a minigame where you have to fly using cuckoos, and I had a horrible experience while doing that. Is there one in the water? No. Are there any over here? Any behind this tree? Any in the tree? What's up here? I know I can climb up these big trees, and there's sometimes things atop them, but doesn't look like it in this case. But I can get a better look. Ah, there's a cuckoo down there. Or rather, up here. Let's grab you. Take you home. Are you not... Can I not... Oh, I can jump with them in my arms, so that's good. Come on, cuckoo! Taking you back home. How did you get out of your pen, anyway? I guess you can fly, so... Man, that lady over there really wants me to go into her shop, but I really don't want... I already bought your armor, lady. I can't afford the, 3,000 rupee worth of armor that you still have left in your shop. That's just a little bit out of my budget at the moment. There's something something shiny over here. Oh, it's just a tree branch. Screw that. I don't need no tree branch. Let's jump up here. I keep forgetting that I can jump. I really do keep forgetting that I can jump. It's kind of a problem. Ooh. A farming hoe? 16 damage? It's fine craftsmanship is sturdy enough to withstand backbreaking fieldwork, but its battle applications are untested. Well, that's a decent weapon, also considering I lost my 20 attack sword a while back. Here's another cuckoo. I should only have two more to get after this one. Come on, cuckoo. Let's go back home. God, he hates me. He really does not want to go back into his pen. Let's toss you in. Go inside. Alright, two more, right? Just two more? Where could they be, though? I haven't really checked down here. It's starting to rain. I don't see any back here. Is there any at the entrance here? No. Ooh, oh, there was a bug there. Oh, I missed it. Oh, there's another bug. Oh, wait, sneak up on it, Link. There we go. Bladed Rhino Beetle. Concoct an elixir that will raise your attack power. Nice. What's back here? Anything interesting? Oh, there's a bow back here. Whoa! And it's a wooden bow. Wow. That sucks. There's five arrows in those pots, though. That's nice. It's like 20 rupees worth of arrows. I need two more cuckoos, though. I don't know where they are. I already got the one that was over here. Can I pick these flowers? No. Doesn't look like it. Maybe they're, like, more up top now. Like, up here? I like that I can just climb up, like, everything. Ooh, what's that? A woodcutter's axe. Oh, I don't really need another one of those, though. Come on, Link, get through there. Whoa, okay, okay, Link. Thank you. Thank you so much. Pick up what? Wait, pick up what? Oh, the pots. Well, they could have arrows in them. No, they did. They had one arrow, though. Man, I need to go take care of that shrine, because that beeping is kind of getting annoying now, but I don't want to leave the village yet until I find all the cuckoos, and it doesn't look like I'm gonna. I don't see any back here, and that's, like, the exit. So, oh, and I had exited, so maybe, please don't be reset. I hope they don't reset. That would be obnoxious. Plus, like, oh, there's something in that waterfall. What is that? I want it. Traveler's sword. Isn't that just like a, yeah, that's like a 5 damage sword. That was not worth my time. Well, I don't know, maybe it was, because my weapon seemed to break pretty easily, so it's always nice just to have a backup something, but how many, okay, let me double check with him, make sure that, like, I haven't found them all already and I'm just running around for no reason. 10 cuckoos total. 8 have returned to him. Yeah, so I need 2 more. Is there one, like, in here? Nope. Not in there. I'm kind of stumped. I don't know where I haven't checked yet. And there's 2 more. You'd think that, like, you'd think that with 2 more being left, I would be able to easily find them, or find them easily enough at any rate. Are there any back here? Cuckoo? Where are you, cuckoo? Oh, I see another Korok circle, though, I want to jump into. Nice. Yaha! You found me! I think that's our, like, 6th one? Yeah, 6 Korok seeds. Nice. Oh, I didn't really think this through, though. I can actually drown in this water. Shit. Come on. Swim your way out. Oh, this is bad. This is, like, actually bad. Oh, there's a big fish there that I kind of want to grab. There's a bass. Link, climb up the rocks. Please just get out of here. Oh, what? What was just happening? What is this red st- Is the blood mood starting? Oh, I've heard of this. I have heard of this. Yep. Oh my god, look at that. The blood moon is starting. Wow. Look at that. Look at that skybox. Holy shit.
Link. Link. Be on your guard. Ganon's power grows. It rises to its peak under the hour of the blood moon. By its glow, the aimless spirits of monsters slain in the name of the light return to flesh. Link, please be careful.
Wow. That's cool. So, I think once every, like, 3 in-game days or something like that, you have a what's called a blood moon, and all of the enemies that you've killed already respawn. Which is both a good and a bad thing, I guess. Whichever way you want to look at it. Oh no. Oh no. Why are there only 5 cuckoo- Oh, jeez. Did I have to do this, like, side quest by, like, a certain time of the day? I bet you I did. Is this the guy? Oh, Master Link, it's gotten so late. Yeah, apparently alright, whatever. I'm gonna leave the cuckoo guy for now. I wanna go into that shrine. Cause I just wanna go in the shrine. I like the shrines. They make you think. And I like having to think and be challenged by a video game. And this one, plus it'll just get rid of the beeping. Talow Neg Shrine. Alright. Oh, plus, the good thing about this is it's a teleport. Once I finish it, it's a teleport back to Kakariko Village. Which will mean I don't have to run here every freaking time I want to come back now. Like, that's the important part. It's fast travel. That's why I want to do it. These bombs are useful not only for dealing damage to monsters, they can also be used to break rocks and weak walls. Yeah, well, obviously. Just like every other Zelda game. Some of the tips are, like, pointless, and then some of them actually do help me a little bit, but... I see a chest right there. But I'm like, what is the catch? What is the catch to this chest? Okay. Shield of the Mind's Eye, 16, wow. A small Sheikah Mage Shield. Its design is intended to increase blind spots without sacrificing too much defense. Oh, my inventory is full. Okay. Go back to the inventory link. Shields. Let's drop the crappy 3 shield. In fact, like, I feel like I don't use my shields enough to even, like, want to hold on to that other 3 shield. So let me just drop both of them. We'll get another one soon, I'm sure, before I even am in need of it. And maybe, like... I don't know, should I save the good shield for, like, when I need it? I feel like I don't use the shield very much. Maybe I should start doing that. What is the catch with these chests? Is there no catch? Is this just, like... Eightfold blade? Yeah, wow, 15 damage. Inventory full again? Inventory management. I need more inventory space. It's becoming a big problem, and this torch so far has not been useful, so I'm getting rid of it. I'm sorry, Torch, but you haven't been useful enough. Eightfold blade. Alright, so 15 damage, that's nice. Oh, here's the catch, right? Okay, I understand now. I get it. Use a side hop to avoid enemy attacks. This will create an opening that you can use to strike back. Target enemy with Z target, strafe with obviously the left analog, and then press X to jump. So that'll let me side hop. Alright, I'm gonna equip the new gear that I actually just got. Cause obviously that's what they give it to you for. Are you gonna fire at me? Wait, what is the... Oh, that's the side hop. Oh, there it is! That's the flurry rush! Yes! I've been trying to do that for, like, ever now, and that's the first time I've been able to do it. Do a backflip to avoid enemy attacks and create an opening to strike back. Target enemy, backpedal, and jump. The only time a video game will ever tell you to backpedal. Come on, attack me. He's gonna yep, there we go. Nice. I probably don't even need to be using this weapon. This looks like more of a tutorial area. You can repel an attack if you parry with your shield just at just the right time. Strike what? All right, ready shield and then parry with A? Did I do it? Oh, I almost did it. Come on. Oh, I got hurt there. Damn it, come on. What is the timing for this? There we go! Nice! What did that do, though? Build up your power and release it to unleash a charge attack. Attach your enemies in this motion to damage them. Hold... Okay, so... Yeah, I already know about this. This is like the spin attack. Ow. Oh, I'm gonna get his Guardian Sword, 20 damage, nice. Very, very nice. Oh, and he dropped some more machinery parts. I have to wonder what these you've done well to learn these crucial skills, now proceed. I have to wonder what these machinery parts are gonna be used for, because I haven't figured out what they're used for yet. Ooh, and there's a chest through there. I mean, we've already gotten so many good things, so many good weapons and stuff. What could possibly be in this chest? That's better than what we've already got. An opal? Yeah, I don't know. It's good to sell, but let's go ahead and talk to this guy. Your triumph over the test of strength subverts a prophecy of ruin from the ashes of Hyrule, something something. In the name of the goddess Hylia, I bestow upon you the spirit orb. I don't like that, like, I don't get to choose when their text disappears, because sometimes it takes me a second to read through it. Especially since I'm reading out loud and not in my head. But whatever, we got another orb. I think that's our first of our next set, yeah. That's like our ninth total, but we need three more for an upgrade. Okay. Well, I think I didn't really get to progress much past Kakariko Village, but I did a lot of extra exploring. So I think I'm probably going to end the stream here, because I've been streaming for like, I don't know, almost 7 hours now. That's a really long time for me to just be sitting and talking the entire time. So I think I'm going to go ahead and end the stream off there. I'm probably going to play a little bit of, like, in my spare time. I'm probably going to do, like, small adventure explore-y stuff. And I'll start progressing the story again in the stream tomorrow. That way, if anybody actually does watch for the story, they won't miss anything important. But thanks for watching. I really appreciate it, especially you, Blue. Like, you've been here for a pretty long time, so it's nice to see friends join in on the chat. I'll grab some fireflies while I'm here. But yeah, I will see everybody later. Thank you.